Welcome to all of you today as we continue our 50-day celebration of the resurrection of our Lord. Alleluia. Please sing our Easter songs with enthusiasm or hum along at home. You can certainly join in on our psalm and our many joyful Alleluias. You can find the words for all today's hymns in the church bulletin, which can be accessed from the parish website. Our presider today will be Father Ron. Our gathering song uses the well-known Ode to Joy tune. Please sing or hum Alleluia, Alleluia with energy as we rejoice in Jesus, our salvation.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the peace of our God, the love of Jesus Christ, and the wisdom of the Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning. As we gather here to celebrate our Mass this weekend, one small point before we begin is last Thursday was Earth Day. And just a reminder to all of us to really respect our earth, the gift of our earth and our environment, that each one of us do our part to help it grow and be strong. As we begin, we say this beautiful prayer with a response to remind us of our baptism. Praise to you, Almighty God and Father, for you have created water to cleanse and to give life.
Sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia to the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the Father's only Son, for you offered yourself on the cross, that in the blood and the water flowing from your side and through your death and resurrection, the church might be born.
Sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia.
Praise to you, God the Holy Spirit, for you anointed Christ at his baptism and in the waters of the Jordan, that we might all be baptized in you.
Sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia to the Lord.
Almighty God, you have called your children to this cleansing water, that they may share in the faith of your church and have eternal life. By the mystery of this consecrated water, lead them to a new and spiritual birth. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. On earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, have Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. God of lasting love, fulfill your plan of salvation to gather into one fold the peoples of the whole world. Let everyone on earth recognize your Christ as the Good Shepherd, who freely lays down his life for all, to take it up again in power. Grant this through Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is a stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia. Give thanks to God, the Lord is good. God's mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, God's mercy endures forever. This is the day that the rejoice and be glad, for this is the day that the Lord has made. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord's right hand is lifted up, the hand of the Lord is mighty. I shall not die, but live to tell the marvelous works. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad, for this is the day that the Lord
from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing God's praise, sing God's praise, sing alleluia to the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know mine and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I laid my life to take it up. And I lay it down on my own. I have the power to lay it down, the power to take it up. This command I have received from my Father, the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing God's praise, sing God's praise, sing alleluia to the
For most of us, I think it's safe to say this image of shepherd is not something we see very much today. It's a very common scene in the early church. It was common scene in the Middle East. People in the early church could really understand what was involved in being a shepherd. It was very real and earthy to them. The biblical figure of shepherd has been romanticized a lot in paintings and pictures and holy cards. Rosy-cheeked young men among pure, white, fluffy sheep on a beautiful green hillside. Very serene and beautiful. I did a little research into what shepherds were like in the time of Jesus. It was a lonely, dirty, dangerous job that could not be managed from a distance. Shepherds lived among the sheep in the filth and stench. The lives of sheep were their primary concern. A sheep would sometimes wander off from others, and when it got lost and could not find its way back, it simply would lie down and it would refuse to budge. The shepherd would seek out the lost sheep, carefully pick it up, and carry it home. There was a personal relationship between the shepherd and each individual sheep. They were not just numbers on a spreadsheet. I believe this image of shepherd points us to God. God is not squeamish. Have you heard God described like that? God is not squeamish. God will not run away when things get messy in our lives. God's hands are dirty. They're not lily white. God's clothes are stained with the waste and mud and blood, the waste, mud, and blood of our roller coaster lives. This God gets in the middle of the mess with us. Does the mess magically disappear? Not most of the time. But there is a sense that we are not alone, and that helps us get through it. A key question for us: are we afraid to share our messes with God? Do we bring God the messes in our lives that we wrestle with? How does the shepherding image of God come alive, become real to people? 2021. I believe most of the time through people. We're all called to be shepherds for each other. We're responsible to pick each other up when we're down. Well, I thought just priests and religious were shepherds. No, we all are if we call ourselves Christian and we mean it. Don't we need special skills and talents, training to do this? No, we need a caring heart, a little common sense, and a few less excuses. What about when you don't have the answers or solutions to people's problems? You don't know what to say or what to do. Just listen and just be there for them. I leave you a story that you've heard, but it makes such a powerful image in my life. A man dreamed he died and went to heaven, and he was met by Jesus. The man had lived a long Christian life, but had been not without some trial and tribulation, as well as joy and victory. As he met with Christ, the man was given a panoramic view of his life, all the highlights and low points. In the review of his life, one of the things that continued throughout were his footprints along the sands of time. The man noticed that those times in his life when it had really been rough, there was only one set of footprints, not two as in the good times. The man turned to the Lord and said, "Lord, I don't understand. You promised to be with me always. But when I look back now, I see that in those really rough times, there was only one set of footprints. Lord, why did you leave me then?" The Lord looked at him, smiled, and said, "Leave you? I didn't leave you at all. Dear friend, if you look at the set of footprints carefully, you'll notice they are a little deeper than the others. Those were the times that I was carrying you. Those were the times I was carrying you. Leave you? I didn't leave you ever." Amen. Today, as we pray our profession of faith, we're going to use the renewal of our vows from our baptism during Lent, during Easter time. Our response is simple. It's "I do," said from our heart with enthusiasm. "Do you renounce sin as to live in the freedom of the children of God?"
I do.
"Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?" I do. Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? I do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? I do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? I do. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? I do. This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
We join together as a community of faith, and we pray intercessions and prayers that we want the whole church to pray in.
For the church and her shepherd Francis, and especially for our shepherds, Danny, Sylvester, Jerry, Ron, Patrick, and Hugo, as they lead us through word and example, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For victims of violence and national upheaval, looking to the Good Shepherd to lead their communities to peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country stumbling and striving toward equality, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Monterey County, moving toward economic and social opening beyond the pandemic, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ill and their caregivers, those who have died and the ones who mourn them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people at San Carlos, those assembled at home, inside the church, and in the courtyard, remembering that the Good Shepherd calls us all to service, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
At this Mass, we are especially remembering Carolyn Carlson, Thomas Goodwine, Carmela and Ivan Pikanich, Dick Rotter, Vita Spadaro, Pauline Campagno, the intentions of Edward Benalis, Isabel Pareja, the intentions of Marciela Rubio, Frank and Pauline Hicks, Tony and Julie Repich, Alfred Bernadette Q, the intentions of Father Jerry while he was away, the intentions of Jim Venturino, Kellyanne Flood, Joe and Joe Piedmonte, Vincent and Jenny Benalis, Diego and Francesco Arancio, Jean Mercurio, Helene Cravello, Mitzi Leiker, Joe Bonanno, Loretta Callahan, Annie Wade, the intentions of Paul Jones and Paul Smith. We now pause to lift up to God our own needs and petitions. For all these intentions, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, make each of us a faithful disciple of Jesus, your Son, our crucified and risen Lord, in whose name we make this prayer, for he is our good shepherd forever and ever.
Amen. Like a shepherd.
And gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. I myself will shepherd them, for others have led them astray,
his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home, leading them home.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, all at all times to acclaim you, Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy Lord, the fount of holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by the cross and resurrection you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, and Danny, our Bishop, Sylvester, our retired Bishop, all the religious and holy people of God. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of the Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now. Jesus, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with you always. God, who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Because the Lord is my shepherd.
everything I need. He lets me rest in the meadow and leads me to the quiet streams. He restores my soul and he leads me in the paths that are right. Lord, you are my shepherd, you are my friend. I want to follow you always, just to follow my friend.
God, your rising is like the mighty wind, and your wisdom like the high waves of the sea. You've shown the power of life in all things, and for this we praise you with our entire being. You have saved our souls from death and have given us a new spirit, a new life. May we never cease in praising you. May we drum with delight and dance with abandon. For you are the God who loves us no matter what. In Jesus we pray. Alleluia. Amen. Let's bow our heads for a wonderful Easter blessing. The Lord be with you. And may God, who by the resurrection of his Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting life, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen. Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living faith in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go and live in peace and bring the presence of the risen Jesus to this world. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Jesus is risen.
Jesus is risen. Let us sing praise to thee.